And there's the bell, ladies and gentlemen. And here we go right off the bat with a six-pack elimination challenge. Look at this, Keo with the running bulldog onto Android 13. And there's the cover. Two. And yeah, that was elimination. Wait a minute, Iron Chef Morimoto with the Iron Chop. The Iron Chop. And Christopher Samuels has been eliminated by Iron Chef Morimoto. And there's a Spine Buster from Mad Max. Wait a minute, we got a double pin here. Two. No, Morimoto kicked out. Well, wait. Here we go. Two. And it looks like, yeah, Kyo Kusanagi has been eliminated. Wait a minute, what's this? Oh, another. What a move that was. Another variation of the Angry Chicken Backbreaker. And he got him. We are down to Iron Chef Morimoto and Mad Max. And now Mad Max could be measuring. Oh, there it is again. The spinning sidewalk slam. Two. And this one's over. We have a new number one contender to the UCWL Cyberspace Championship. Oh, wait a minute. Gordon Ramsay threw Iron Chef Morimoto back in the ring. And now he's putting the boots to him. Oh, what the hell is this? And there's the bell, ladies and gentlemen, and we are underway with our main event, a six-pack elimination challenge to determine the number one contender to the UCWL Championship. There's the Metalocalypse, and Reno Reigns is our first elimination in this matchup. And wait a minute, Naruto with the Rasengan on Terry Bogard, and Bogard's been eliminated. It's down to Naruto Uzumaki, Yuri Boyka. Wait a minute, wait a minute. One, two. Oh my God! Wait a minute. What the hell? Nathan Explosion was just eliminated by Levi Ackerman. And now look at this. Nathan pulled Levi out of the ring. And now look at this. Oh, wait a minute, wait a minute. What? Nathan, oh my God, no. No, 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 no. Oh my God! Naruto's home on the top rope. He's measuring Boyka. What's he got planned here? Naruto. Here he comes off the top. Oh! And this time, he's nowhere near the ropes. And it's over. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a new number one contender to the UCWL Championship.
Yeah!
Ladies and gentlemen, CAW fans worldwide, we are live here tonight from Raleigh, North Carolina, as we continue on the road to UCWL's next mega event, Cold Day in Hell, as we welcome you to episode 10 of the Universal Championship Wrestling League. Hello everyone, this is V-Pac here once again as we continue on the road to UCWL's next mega event, Cold Day in Hell, which will be live from Austin, Texas in just a few weeks' time. And ladies and gentlemen, last week we crowned a new number one contender for the UCWL Championship, and tonight I am proud to say that here tonight we will see a face-to-face confrontation between the UCWL Champion, the Green Arrow, and his new number one contender, the most complete fighter in the world, Yuri Boyka. What's going to happen when those two come face-to-face tonight? Also tonight, we're going to see Cruiser X Division action as Parko Fogore goes one-on-one with Batsu Ichibanji. That is going to be an incredible match right there. Also tonight, ladies and gentlemen, the legendary Hungry Wolf, Terry Bogard, goes one-on-one with Chef Gordon Ramsay. That should be another intense matchup right there. And of course, let's not forget tonight, our main event, a tag team no holds barred match between the Reactors and the Black Dragon. This one's been stemming for ever since UCWL's inception. But ladies and gentlemen, we are kicking things off with this match. It's Jack going one-on-one with Android 13. Let's head up to Shao Curtis for the introductions to this matchup.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your opening contest for this evening, and it's set for one fall.
Gentlemen, like I said, we are kicking off with this match here, as listen to this ovation as Jack makes his way to the ring. And right now we're going to take you back to our previous episode and show you what happened with earlier in the night. Jack got ambushed by Skeletor, preventing him from competing in the six-pack elimination challenge for the Cyberspace Championship number one contendership. But Jack was able to retaliate later in the night and prevented Skeletor from competing in the six-pack elimination challenge for the number one contendership for the UCWL Championship. And as a result of the spewing, out-of-control brawling between both Jack and Skeletor, General Manager Phil Coulson has made it official. Jack is going to go one-on-one with Skeletor at Cold Day in Hell. Well, in any case, ladies and gentlemen, I do believe this is going to be Jack's first matchup since episode 2, which happens to be the episode where Jack was ambushed by Skeletor. Well, in any case, ladies and gentlemen, Jack is definitely going to have his hands full here tonight as he's set to go one-on-one with his opponent coming out right now.
From the Red Ribbon Army, Android 13.
And ladies and gentlemen, here comes Jack's opponent tonight, Android 13, who is actually one of the other six men that was in that match to determine the number one contendership for the Cyberspace Championship on our last episode. And Android 13, of course, came up short in that matchup. Of course, that match was won by Mad Max. As a result, Mad Max will challenge Monkey D. Luffy for the UCWL Cyberspace Championship at Cold Day in Hell. In any case, right now, Android 13 has an opportunity to rebound from that huge loss if he can pick up a huge victory here tonight over Jack in this one-on-one contest to kick off Episode 10. And there's the bell, ladies and gentlemen, and here we go, kicking off the action here on episode 10, as Jack goes one-on-one with Android 13. And Jack taking the early advantage here in this matchup with that neck breaker, and he follows it up with that running drop kick to the side of the head of Android 13. Of course, now Android 13, though, counters into that shoulder breaker. Well, in any case, I'm pretty sure Jack is going to have to maintain his focus here. I'm sure he's glad to know that Skeletor is not here tonight due to the, due to what happened on the last episode. Jack now taking advantage of this, taking advantage here, dropping the elbow right into the lower back of Android 13. Of course, now Jack, no, here's a counter by Android 13 into a short arm clothesline, taking down the savior of Haven City. Here's the, oh wow, not even a one count. Jack quickly kicking out. Jack now with the Irish whip. Look at this. Luthez press. And just hammering away on Android 13. You gotta wonder if he's seeing Skeletor instead of Android 13 in this matchup. Jack off the top rope with a huge elbow drop right into the chest. And now another elbow drop by Jack. Oh wait, here we go. Another shoulder block there by Android 13. The Android 13, look at that clubbing blow to the back of Jack. That kind of rhymes. Anyways, Android 13 with that forearm right to the forehead of Jack now. And he follows it up with a knee drop. Yeah. Android 13 coming off the ropes, hitting that axe handle. I don't think he got all of it, though. Okay, so Android 13 now definitely got all of that off the second rope with the forearm. Here's the cover on Jack. Two and no. Jack just kicking out at two. Android 13 now. Another clubbing blow to the back of Jack. Of course, this would be a huge victory for Android 13. This would definitely move him up the ranks for maybe a potential title shot at the Cyberspace Championship. Look at this, Android 13 going to work on Jack. Knee to the midsection. And look at that! Standing axe kick onto Jack. Now look at this, stepping on the shoulder of Jack as well. Jack is not in good shape here. You gotta wonder if that backstage assault from Skeletor is still affecting him from our last episode. Android 13 now. What, measuring Jack. Oh wait, what's this? Oh wait a minute, wait a minute. Oh wait a second. Oh, he calls that the TH Death Bomb. One, two, and no. Android 13 tried to put him away with his finisher, the TH Death Bomb. And yes, the TH stands for Trucker Hat. And I guess I think he may have tried that a little bit too early. As Android 13 now continuing the assault on Jack. And look at that, smothering the face of Jack right into the canvas. And now look at this. No, wait, Jack! With a kick to the face. And now look at this. Jack with the Blue Eco Bomb. Blue Eco Bomb. Two. And only a two count. Jack trying to put him away with the Blue Eco Bomb. But to no avail. And now Jack drops the forearm onto Android 13. And it was raining mounted punches after punch after punch on Android 13. Well, it's the Android 13 Snapmare Takeover. and a shot right to the side of Jack's face. And now look at this, try to apply the cross arm breaker. Instead, he let go of the hold. I guess he's going to try something else here. Oh, wait. Knee to the midsection. And there's that axe kick again. That impressive standing axe kick from Android 13. And Android 13 follows it up with a knee drop. And another forearm smash. Alright, so Android 13's definitely been very impressive in this matchup so far. Though he's been unable to put Jack away. Wait, Jack counters with the jawbreaker. But look at this, Android 13 right back on the attack. I think Jack was trying to catch his breath and was unable to capitalize as Android 13 went for the cover and only got a two count. Jack in a lot of trouble here. Another knee to the midsection, and there's another axe kick. Android 13 trying to put Jack away. Oh wait, look at this, Jack fighting back. Almost like an inverted face buster right there. And now Jack, look at this. Running drop kick to the side of the head of Android 13. And these fans are clearly behind Jack here tonight. Jack now, knife edge chop. Continuing to fight back here. Sending Android 13 off the ropes. Catches him with the corkscrew neck breaker. Here's the cover. One, two, and no. Android 13 kicking out of two. Jack couldn't believe it either. Wait, Jack now. Fireman's carry. What's this? Oh, a flapjack there. I thought he was gonna go for the Eco Maker. Instead, he went for that flapjack. Android 13 counters with that shoulder block. And now Android 13, what's this? Nice short arm clothesline there. Taking Jack down to the canvas. But again, Jack counters with that jawbreaker. Now look at this, going right to work on Android 13. Sending him to the corner. Running drop kick connects. And now Jack picking up Android 13. Forearm shot, knocking him right into the ropes. And now Jack follows it up with a guillotine. Just launching Android 13 neck first into the bottom rope. Jack down. No, there's a forearm from Android 13. Look at this, Android 13 with those right hands. Now look at this. Nice takeover suplex there from Android 13. Now look at this, here's the cover on Jack. Two, and no. Jack kicking out at two. So far, it's been an incredible match to kick things off here on episode 10. Android 13 now, snap air takeover to the chin lock. And there you see Jack now, trying to get to his feet. Elbows to the midsection. And now Jack sending Android 13 to the corner. Oh wait, we've seen him do this before. Jack with the exploder suplex in the corner. He usually likes to use that to set up for his finisher. Jack now could be looking for the Eco Maker. I mean, look at this. Oh, look at that. A new variation of the Eco Maker. Here's the cover two. And this one's over. Incredible match to kick things off here on episode 10. As Jack emerges victorious here tonight over Android 13. As we take a look at some of the action that took place during this matchup. Android 13 tried putting Jack away earlier with this move. He calls the TH Death Bomb. Unfortunately, it was not enough to put Jack away, as Jack still had plenty left in the tank to kick out of that. Jack would fight back, hit him with his Blue Eco Bomb. Unfortunately, that was not enough to put away Android 13. Of course, the match would continue going back and forth between both men. There you see Android 13 trying to go for the cover. But again, Jack would kick out at two. And this is where the end happened. This is the end, beginning of the end right here, as Jack hit that Exploder Suplex in the corner. And then he followed up with this new version of the Eco Maker, as he would quickly gut the cover, the two, and the three. Your winner is Jack, as he gains momentum heading into his match with Skeletor at Cold Day in Hell.
Here is your winner, Jack.
And I gotta bet you Skeletor is probably watching this wherever he is, probably sitting at his throne in Eternia, recuperating from that incident that happened on our last episode, as Jack's celebrating in the ring. And oh, wait a minute, he's got a microphone. We're gonna hear from him. Incredibly strong words there by Jack. And I'm definitely sure Skeletor heard every single one of them. What's going to happen when those two go one-on-one at Cold Day in Hell? In the case, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back. Wait! Oh my God! What the hell? Monkey D. Luffy just got done with an interview with Jackie Rivera, and he turned around and walked right into that sidewalk slam from Mad Max. We need some help out here. We need some help in the back for Luffy.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next contest is set for one fall.
Ladies and gentlemen, as Terry Bogard makes his way to the ring, hopefully we'll get an update on the condition of Monkey D. Luffy before the night is over. I cannot believe what we just saw. Luffy just got literally done with an interview with Jackie Rivera, and he walked right into that spinning sidewalk slam from Mad Max. And Mad Max is definitely seems more determined than ever to walk out a cold day in hell with that cyberspace championship. He was clearly sending a message to Luffy. Well, in any case, ladies and gentlemen, Terry Bogard is in the ring as we await his opponent. Gentlemen, speaking of despicable human beings like Mad Max, here comes another man who I can fit in that category, Chef Gordon Ramsay. And if you recall in the last episode, after in that six-pack elimination challenge when Mad Max won that matchup, pinning Iron Chef Morimoto last, Gordon Ramsay came back out and picked the bones of what was left of Iron Chef Morimoto. And he just sees it, and he just definitely gloated about it. But in any case, he's now set to go one-on-one with the legendary Hungry Wolf Terry Bogard here tonight on episode 10. And there's the bell, ladies and gentlemen, and here we go with our second match of the night here, as Gordon Ramsay set to go one-on-one with Terry Bogard. And Ramsay taking early advantage of this matchup with that back suplex onto Bogard. And he follows it up with another straight up vertical suplex. And look at this, a little bit of showboating there. And look at that, he's paying for it right now with that huge drop kick by Terry Bogard. And Bogard follows it up with a standing moonsault and a standing shooting star press. Bogard down on the second rope. Went for the rolling senton, and Ramsay moved out of the way. Of course, but look at that. Bogard back in control with that arm drag. And now slamming the arm of Gordon Ramsay into the canvas. I was trying to say, Ramsay was definitely gloating about what he did to Iron Chef Morimoto, to those that would listen to him in the back. Now look at this, look at that, blocking Terry Bogard's right hand, and there's a huge drop kick by Gordon Ramsay. As Ramsay is retaking control of this matchup, as he's wrenching on the neck of Terry Bogard. Oh, look at that, Bogard fights out of it. And look at that. No. Ramsey tripping Terry Bogard now. What is the chef from Hell's Kitchen have planned now? Going to work on the leg of the legendary Hungry Wolf. And he does it again. Gordon Ramsay now. Well, this is actually a very smart move on the part of Ramsay, focusing on the legs of Terry Bogard. One, two, and no. Only a two count on the cover. As I was saying, if you damage the legs of Terry Bogard, you take away some of his striking power. Although that's still Bogard fighting back now. Although this Bogard, look at this. Oh, what a move that was! A cradle Michinoku driver. And now Bogard on the ring apron. What is this? Oh, what a move that was! A springboard 450 splash. Right onto Gordon Ramsay. And now look at this. Bogard follows it up with the Rolling Thunder. Oh, wait a minute. We could be seeing it early. Are we seeing it? Oh, look at that! There it is, the burning knuckle! Terry Bogard with the burning knuckle! And Ramsay kicks out at two. Terry Bogard thought he had it there with the burning knuckle, but Gordon Ramsay still has plenty of left in the tank. As there you see Terry Bogard now wrenching on Ramsay's neck. Oh, that though, Ramsay was able to escape out of it. Wait, what is this? Oh, nice move there by Terry Bogard. It looked like Ramsay was going to try some kind of power bomb, but Bogard countered the Hurricane Rod, and he falls up with a drop kick. And now Bogard on the top rope. What is this? He's measuring Gordon Ramsay. Oh, what a move that was! Diving Hurricane Rod. Taking down the chef from Hell's Kitchen. Terry Bogard now placing Gordon Ramsay on the top rope. And look at that! What agility and what skill there from Terry Bogard. Bogard now, look at this. Fujiwara armbar. Trying to get a submission here onto Gordon Ramsay. Oh, wait, look at that. Ramsay rolling Terry Bogard off of him. And there's a right hand there. A left hand, my bad, from Ramsay. He falls it up with the F word. That modified stutter. He calls the F word. And now Gordon Ramsay has taken control of this matchup. Ramsay now. What's he got playing here for Bogard? Oh, look at that. Snap DDT taking Terry Bogard down to the canvas. Oh, this isn't looking good here. This is not looking good. Right hand. And there's the ride to Hell's Kitchen. The ride to Hell's Kitchen. Will this be it? No. Terry Bogard kicking out of the ride to Hell's Kitchen. We have seen Gordon Ramsay put a lot of people away with that move. But Terry Bogard was able to kick out of it. And wait, what has Ramsay got? What's this? Oh, God. Ramsay, what? Oh, God. This is not good. Oh! Gordon Ramsay with that elevated neck breaker. And now Ramsay on the top rope. Oh, he's telling Bogard to get up. This is not good. Oh, look at that. Terry Bogard scouted it. Missile dropkick missed, but Ramsey's back in control. And now Gordon Ramsay with another swinging neck breaker. Here's the cover. Two and no. Terry Bogard again. Kicking out of the count of two. And Ramsay's begging him to get up now. as he steps on the hand of Terry Bogard, followed by the back of his head. Now Gordon Ramsay with the elbow drop. And now the chef from Hell's Kitchen on the top rope. He's measuring Terry Bogard. The legendary Hungry Wolf is in trouble here. Look at that, rock, almost like a famous or off the top rope by Gordon Ramsay. And now Ramsay. Oh, here we go again. Another F word. Another F word. And now Terry Bogard is in a lot of trouble. Oh, here we go again. If Ramsay hits this again, you might as well get the three count here. And there it is. The ride to Hell's Kitchen. Well, wait a minute. Wait a minute, that's Iron Chef Morimoto's music! Is Iron Chef Morimoto here? These fans are going nuts here! Is Iron Chef Morimoto here? Oh, wait a minute. Iron Chef Morimoto's music provided distraction. Ramsay now. He's measuring Terry Bogard. Wait! Oh! What a move by Bogard! From out of nowhere! He calls that the Power Geyser! And now Terry Bogard! Fighting back here! Super Kick connects! Terry Bogard now in control of this matchup! Look at this! Another Rolling Thunder! Rolling Thunder connects! And now Bogard climbing the top rope! He's measuring Gordon Ramsay! And look at that! Somersault senton attack there! And now Bogard! He's measuring Ramsay! Are we going to see it for the second time in this match? There it is! The Burning Knuckle! Terry Bogard with the Burning Knuckle! Will this do it? Two! He got him! Incredibly back and forth match between Terry Bogard and Chef Gordon Ramsay. But in the end, it was a slight distraction that caused the outcome of this matchup. There you see Terry Bogard hitting the Burning Knuckle for the first time in this match. Of course, we saw on display his abilities. But there you see Gordon Ramsay with the first F word. And I believe that was the first attempt at the ride to Hell's Kitchen. Ramsay, though, would only get a two count after the first one. Then he would hit this incredibly rope-hung swinging neck breaker. And he followed up with a famous or off the top rope. And followed again by the second F word. And then he would hit the ride to Hell's Kitchen again. And we thought it was over here until Iron Chef Morimoto's music started playing, causing a slight distraction. It allowed Terry Bogard to recuperate, hit Gordon Ramsay with the Power Geyser, and then hit him with the Burning Knuckle for the second time in this match. As there you see, Terry Bogard picks up the win here tonight on Episode 10. Impressive victory here for the legendary Hungry Wolf. But you definitely know Gordon Ramsay's got to be livid over what happened. We'll be right back.
Bring on the war. Let us play the toll. This is my own.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to UCWL Episode 10. And if you're just joining us, you missed this. Gordon Ramsay was in the middle of a match with Terry Bogard. It looked like Ramsay had the match won until Iron Chef Morimoto's music started playing. We thought the Iron Chef was here, but it turned out to be just a distraction. But the distraction was all it took for Terry Bogard to regain control of this matchup and pick up the victory with the burning knuckle over Chef Gordon Ramsay. Bo Dennis. Of course, this is what happened after Bo Dennis' match with Bindi on episode 9. As this capacity crowd, oh, wait a minute. There you see the referee trying to get in between Daisy and Bo, and here we go. These two women slugging it out here. Here comes security, and the referee's trying to get between these two, and here we go again. Both of these ladies want to tear each other apart. It wouldn't take long for security to break them apart, but then Daisy would storm into Coulson's office. Definitely a huge decision to make for Daisy Johnson, and so far we have not heard a single word from her as to whether or not what her decision is going to be. Well, in any case, ladies and gentlemen, coming up next is a highly anticipated match that I have been looking forward to all... Wait, what the... Oh, no. No. No, 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 no. Oh, God. He's back. Ladies and gentlemen, we were supposed to have our highly anticipated Cruiser X Division bout coming up next, but it looks like we're being interrupted by the returning PS Power. And we have not seen PS Power, not since he got his brains rattled, courtesy of Yuri Boyka. That was back in the quarterfinals of the Cyberspace Championship Tournament. PS Power suffered a concussion during that matchup, and as a result, he's been on the shelf. But it looks like he's back. And if he's out here, ladies and gentlemen, that can only mean one thing. He's gonna rant. And who knows what he's gonna rant about this time. Is there any chance we can cut this mic off? Look at this guy's shirt, for God's sake. Oh, God, he's grabbing a microphone. Oh, God, here we go. He's returned all right, but nobody wants him here. I don't know if he's aware of this, but that's not the main event anymore. Is he done yet? Oh, wait a minute, what is this? Well, look at this, ladies and gentlemen. PS Powers ranting is taking an unscheduled interruption here by Keith Abicary. I mean, I never thought in a million years I'd ever be so happy to see Keith Abicary out here. I mean, why is Keith Abicary out here? And I think the fans are actually cheering for him, mainly because he came out here and he stopped PS Power's ongoing rant. And we're about to see what's going to happen now. Ooh, shots fired. Shots fired and target destroyed with that one. Oh, wait a minute. Look at this. Keith Abicary attacking PS Power. These fans are going nuts for it. Keith Abicary laying the smackdown on PS Power. And these fans are going nuts for it. Oh, wait, now PS Power with a forearm. And now look at this, PS Power trying to get out of there. I have no idea what we just witnessed, ladies and gentlemen. A very strange, bizarre encounter between these two individuals. But nonetheless, it looks like Keith Abicary standing tall here over PS Power. Well, in case, well, what are we doing now? Oh, we'll be right back.
This is going to reignite the era of wonder.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are live for the Royal Rumble.
ladies and gentlemen, this next contest is a Cruiser X Division match, and it is set for one fall.
Gentlemen, welcome back to UCWL episode 10. I'm still trying to wrap my head around what we just saw between PS Power and Keith Avicari. Well, in any case, ladies and gentlemen, we are about to get set for the match that we were supposed to have before PS Power came out and interrupted everything. As you can see, here's Parco Fagore entering the ring now. Of course, the last time we saw Parco Fagore was on the Rise to Glory pre-show. He lost to Mad Max. Well, in the case, now he's back in the Cruiser X Division here tonight as we now await his opponent. And here he is, ladies and gentlemen, Parco Fagore's opponent here tonight, Batsu Ichimonji, who's set to make his singles debut here tonight on episode 10. Of course, the last time we did see Batsu Ichimonji was during the pilot episode for UCWL, all the way back to last summer. He was part of that six-pack elimination challenge previewing the Cruiser X Division, as was his opponent, Parco Fagore. I don't know much about Batsu, other than the fact that from what I've been told, he's a very intense striker. And it looks like we're going to find out exactly if he can live up to his reputation here tonight on episode 10. And there's the bell, ladies and gentlemen. And this match is already underway as Parco Fagore runs in and hits Batsu with the Hurricane Rana. And now look at this. Parco with the big knee right to the face of Batsu. Needless to say, things not starting off well for Batsu Ichimonji here. But Batsu counters with a jawbreaker. Oh my god, what a knee to the face there. A Parco, and he followed up with a second one. Now look at this. What's Batsu doing here? It's like a suplex attempt here, but oh no, look at that. Parco lands on his feet. And Parco Fagore with a reverse DDT. Now look at this. Parco kick to the midsection. Wait, what is this? Oh, what a move that was. Like a straight jacket backstabber. And now Parco going up to the top rope. Connects with the elbow drop. Parco Fagore now. Oh, wait, no, look at this. Counter there by Batsu. And then the arm drag. And he follows it up with another vicious kick. Elbow strike there from Batsu. And another. Oh, wait, what is this? Oh, God. Vicious kick right to the chest. Parco Fagore could have a couple of broken ribs after that. Look at this springboard elbow drop from Batsu Ichimonji. Parco Fagore, though, sent him in the corner, but Batsu fought out of it, only to be met with an arm drag and another Hurricane Rana there from Parco Fulgore. Parco, oh, look at that! The supermodel kick! Parco Fulgore with a supermodel kick, and now what? Parco Fulgore, look at that, he caught it, caught him with it! The beauty shot! He calls that the beauty shot, two, and no! That would have been a huge upset right there if Parco Fulgore could have picked up the victory with the beauty shot. As there you see Batsu with that a kick right to the face, and he follows it up with a cradle Michinoku driver. I can't. That was that very close call there. And now Parco Fulgore back to his feet. Oh, wait, Batsu now. What's this? Fireman's carry. Oh, wait, no, look at that. Nice counter upon counter there. Oh! And another kick from Batsu. And a running clothesline. And another one. And Batsu with a trip. Batsu Ichimonji now. Fireman's carry. What's this? Ooh! Fireman's carry roundhouse kick connecting. And now look at this. Another series of kicks. This guy is definitely living up to the reputation of being a very intense striker. But Parco Fulgore trying to hold his own here. Spinning back kick blocked there by Parco. And speaking of kicks, there's another supermodel kick there from Parco Fulgore. Here's the cover. Two and no. And look at that. Parco with a kick of his own. Now Parco Fulgore trying to catch his wind. Those strikes look like they've been very lethal on him. Now look at this, Parco Fulgore with a neck breaker. Taking down Batsu Ichimonji. And you can see that Batsu's strikes definitely seem to have an effect on Parco. Parco's not as being as flamboyant as he's used to, as we're used to seeing him. Snap DDT connects. Oh, wait a minute, he could be going for another beauty shot. He could be setting up for another beauty shot. And there it is! Another beauty shot. This could do it right here. Two. Oh, I thought that was three. And so did Parco. Parco Fulgore thought he got the three count. But Batsu must have just gotten up at 2 3/4. And Parco is pissed now. Parco Fulgore, another supermodel kick! A third supermodel kick in this matchup. But Parco not going for the cover. Maybe letting his anger blind him. And Batsu taking down Parco Fulgore. And now, wait, here we go again. Fireman's carry. And another roundhouse kick to the back of the head. That could do it. Here's the cover. One, two, and no. I have no idea what to call that fireman's carry roundhouse kick. Oh, wait a minute. What's Batsu doing now? Oh, wait. Batsu. Fireman's carry again. What's this? A GTS! GTS. And oh, wait, he's not done. Oh, God! He calls that combination the Burning Rush. Will this do it? And it does. Batsu Ichimonji living up to his reputation here tonight. What a series of strikes those were to end this matchup. And let's take a look at some of the action that we saw during this matchup. Parco Fulgore put up a valiant effort. But there you see one of Batsu's vicious kicks. But there you see Parco with the first of three supermodel kicks. And they tried putting him away with the beauty shot. Unfortunately, he didn't get it here. Batsu, though, that would fight back, hitting with a series of clotheslines, and then tripping Parko. And then he would hit him, and then he would hit Parko Vigoro with this fireman's carry roundhouse kick combination. But Parko would fight back, hit him with that super kick, supermodel kick, my bad. And then a second beauty shot. Unfortunately, this was a very close call here. It looked like for sure he may have gotten the three count, but Batsu just getting the shoulder up. He hits that fireman's carry roundhouse kick again. And then he would finish it, Parko off with this combination GTS running kick he calls the Burning Rush. And the Burning Rush in the end would get the victory for Batsu Ichimonji here tonight on episode 10. What an incredible singles debut this was here tonight for Batsu Ichimonji. I can only say I hope the rest of the stars of the Cruiser X Division are on the lookout for this guy. I got a feeling he's got a very bright future ahead of him. Well, in any case, ladies and gentlemen, don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. I'm feeling it. Well, how about that, ladies and gentlemen? It looks like we're going to see Gordon Ramsay versus Iron Chef Morimoto round two at Cold Day in Hell now. Well, in any case, ladies and gentlemen, we promised you a face-to-face between champion and challenger, and that's coming up next. Actually, I take that back. It's coming up right now. And there he is, ladies and gentlemen, appearing for the first time since he successfully defended the UCWL Championship at Rise to Glory. Here's our reigning and defending champion, the Emerald Archer himself, the Green Arrow, who we now know has a date with the self-proclaimed most complete fighter in the world, Yuri Boyka, at our next mega event, Cold Day in Hell. And he promised he'd come face to face with him here tonight. And who knows what we're going to expect when these two come face to face in that ring coming up right now. The UCWL champion definitely seems pumped up here tonight as he awaits his opponent for Cold Day in Hell to come to the ring. And here, oh boy, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Wait a minute. What is this? That's Gaga, ladies and gentlemen. That's Boyka's advocate slash manager, but where the hell is Yuri Boyka? This is very unusual. You don't usually see one without the other here, ladies and gentlemen. I think it's Gaga's coming to the ring now, and Green Arrow looks just as confused as all of us here right now. In any case, Gaga looks like he's about to grab a microphone, and we're going to hear from the advocate for Yuri Boyka. Definitely some strong comments there from Gaga. But I can tell you right now, I definitely believe the Green Arrow is going to back up his claims when those when Arrow and Boyka go. Wait a minute! What the hell? I thought Boyka wasn't here tonight! Where the hell did he come from? Oh God, look at this, Boyka! Oh, Jesus Christ! Look at these, Boyka with these knees right to the midsection of the UCWL champion, completely blindsiding him. I thought Boyka wasn't here tonight. And I got a feeling this was just a complete setup. Oh God, what is this? Oh Jesus! Yuri Boyka with that powerbomb. I got a feeling this whole thing was just a setup by Gaga and Yuri Boyka. Another German there from Boyka. Oh Jesus! Just dumping the UCWL champion right on his head. Come on, enough is enough. Boyka now. Oh, come on. Stop this. Oh, Jesus, the tornado kick. Right to the head of the Green Arrow. Green Arrow obviously was blindsided. Oh, God, what now? What now? Oh, no. Oh, no. The Gogo Pilata. Oh, come on, ref. Get him off of him. This isn't a safe, this isn't even a match! Where the hell's our damn security? Get this guy off the UCWL champion! He's gonna crush his neck! Boyka with this devastating Gogo Pilata submission hold on the Green Arrow! Come on, ref, get him off! This is completely uncalled for! He's gonna crush the Green Arrow's neck! Come on! Somebody do something! Get this guy off of him! Oh, Jesus! I think finally Boyka's letting go of the hold. This was obviously a trap laid out by Gaga and Yuri Boyka here tonight to send a message to the UCWL champion. Oh, Jesus. Green Arrow's hurt, ladies and gentlemen. I think the Green Arrow's hurt. We need some help out here for the Green Arrow. And who knows what kind of condition now he's going to be in for their title match, A Cold Day in Hell. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back.
is Video Game Wrestling Network, the only network for...
It is free!
Austin, I'm not home! My God!
Why is the Video Game Wrestling Network the only network for...
Start it off! And, oh! Out of nowhere!
Don't fall on the steel. Oh my God! Oh! Superplex! What a brutal match we have just seen.
Why is Video Game Wrestling Network the only network for...
Daniel Bars?
Oh my God!
What's gonna happen?
BSKO! There it is!
King charges! Oh! He goes over the top! Spider-Man!
Why?
This is the only place we want to be.
Video Game Wrestling Network, the only network for you. Experience the best in CAW wrestling. Only on Video Game Wrestling Network.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to UCWL Episode 10. And if you're just joining us, this is what you just missed before the commercial. Yuri Boyka blindsiding the UCWL champion, the Green Arrow. Green Arrow was supposed to come face-to-face tonight with Boyka. And then Gaga came out, Boyka's advocate, and told him Boyka wasn't here. But this was clearly a deceptive trap laid by Gaga and Boyka to send a message to the UCWL champion. And then, of course, after that tornado kick, Boyka would do this. He would lock on the Go-Go Pilata, this devastating submission hold, which is designed to crush the necks. We've seen people bleed eternally from this very hold. And Boyka had this hold on him for a very long time. And nonetheless, ladies and gentlemen, during the commercial break, the Green Arrow had to be helped to the back. But in any case, we want to change gears for just a moment now. Well, if you notice, there's one person that's been absent here tonight. Of course, that was Nathan Explosion. Of course, Nathan Explosion has been barred from the arena here tonight, courtesy of General Manager Phil Coulson. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we want to take you back to Episode 9 and show you why Nathan Explosion is barred from the arena here tonight. And here's the reason why. It's down to Naruto Uzumaki, Yuri Boyka. Wait a minute. 1, 2. Oh my God! Levi Ackerman just eliminated Nathan Explosion. Nathan Explosion's not... What? Wait a minute! What the hell? Nathan Explosion was just eliminated by Levi Ackerman. And now look at this! Nathan pulled Levi out of the ring. And now look at this! As Nathan continues to go to work on him, slamming him into the barricade. Come on, this is uncalled for. Come on, enough is enough! Oh, wait a minute, what? Nathan, oh my God, no! Oh my God! Nathan Explosion just chokeslammed Levi Ackerman right through the Dutch announce table. I think we're gonna need some help from Levi! And it was because of these actions after he got eliminated from the six-pack elimination challenge on our last episode, and is the main reason why Nathan Explosion has been barred from the arena here tonight. But that's not going to stop him on our next episode. In any case, ladies and gentlemen, Nathan Explosion is set to return on our next episode, episode 11. And what is next for Nathan Explosion now that he's been eliminated from the number one contendership for the UCWL Championship? I guess we're going to find out on episode 11. Nonetheless, ladies and gentlemen, we're now getting set for our huge main event here tonight. A tag team no holds barred match. This match has been brewing ever since UCWL's inception. And let's head up to Shao Curtis for the introductions for this, for our main event right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next contest is your main event of the evening. And it is a tag team, no holds barred match, and it is set for 1-4.
Ever since UCWL's inception, the team of the Black Dragon, Kano and Tremor, have been going head-to-head with their opponents here tonight. We saw them face off at Rise to Glory, UCWL's inaugural mega event, where they came up short in that matchup, but then afterwards laid an assault on the Reactors, which of course led to that backstage brawl that happened on episode 8, which has now led us to here. Let's hope that this situation between these two teams can finally be resolved here, as we are set to await the Reactors coming out next.
Team number 2, the team of Tyrone Magnus and Akasan, the Reactors.
And ladies and gentlemen, listen to this reaction for the Reactors as they make their way to the ring. Oh, wait a minute, look at this! They're not wasting any time! The Reactors, Tyrone Magnus and Akasan bolting into the ring and going right after the Black Dragon. They've been waiting for this ever since they got ambushed at Rise to Glory after they were victorious in the tag team match. And now you gotta wonder if, both teams are trying to gain momentum here. Especially, and there's the bell. The bell is officially rung. And I don't think either one of these four men care. Needless to say, both of these teams trying to look for momentum. Especially with the fact that we now have tag team championships on the way. That's right, we're going to be crowning UCWL's inaugural tag team champions at Cold Day in Hell in that tag team turmoil match. And of course, both the Reactors and the Black Dragon are going to be in that matchup along with eight other teams. As there you see Kano with a German suplex on the Tyrone Magnus on the outside. Now look at this, Akasan trying to... Wait, what is this? Look at this, both... Akasan went back in the ring to fight Tremor. Tyrone Magnus and Kano are battling up the entrance ramp here. I mean, I know this is a tag team match, supposed to be no holds barred. I'm not sure if that means false count anywhere either. I guess Akasan sending Tremor to the outside. Well, that's Akasan and Tremor now fighting on the outside. Meanwhile, we got Kano and Tyrone Magnus on the entrance ramp. Tyrone Magnus and Kano, I think they're heading to the back. Meanwhile, we got Akasan and Tremor now battling at the ringside area. Now look at this, now they're heading up the ramp as well. Look at this, Tyrone Magnus heading to the back. Kano's in pursuit. And there you see Akasan and Tremor. They're now battling on the entrance ramp. It's not a very safe place to be fighting. Now they're on the stage. As Akasan with a leg drop. and an elbow drop and a forearm smash on a tremor. Things are not... This match is definitely already broken down. Already. Now there's Akasan dragging Tremor to the back. Now look at this. Ladies and gentlemen, I can definitely tell you, I believe this match has been thrown out already. Look at this. Now both teams are fighting in the back. Look at this. Kano going after Akasan. Tremor and Tyrone Magnus battling it out. All hell's definitely breaking loose here. Look at this now. Akasan launching Kano right into the floor. And now going back to work on Tremor. This is not good, ladies and gentlemen. As both of these teams fighting in the back. Almost reminiscent of Episode 8. And I think security's just letting these two guys fight at it for a little while. Oh, Jesus. Akasan launching Tremor right into that metal box. And he does it again. And now look at this. Kano going to work on Tyrone Magnus. This is all-out chaos here, ladies and gentlemen. Not even the ring could contain both of these teams. Magnus now, vicious knee to the face of Kano. And slamming Kano into that metal box. Meanwhile, Tremor and Akasan continue to go at it here. And Tyrone Magnus thrown onto the concrete floor. Oh, Jesus, Akasan with a DDT on the Tremor. This is not looking good. Akasan and Kano, and now Tyrone Magnus up to his feet as well. The reactors now. The hangman neckbreaker there by Akasan. And now there's both members of the reactors going to work on Kano. Tremor is out on the floor after that DDT. And oh God! Tyrone Magnus launching Kano into those boxes. And now look at this. Kano continuing to fight here. I mean, you got, whether you like him or you hate him, you got to admit Kano's one tough son of a bitch. As he's taking the fight to both members of the reactors despite his tag team partner being laid out. This has just turned into all-out chaos and oh God! A front Russian leg sweep. Down goes Kano. The reactors have laid out the Black Dragon and wait, what? I'm being told, wait, what is this? Wait a minute, that's MI-13 and the Wing Commanders. Well, what the hell? Another part of the building here. MI-13, Captain Britain and Union Jack. And then they're fighting off the Wing Commanders, Christopher Blair and Todd Marshall. I mean, what the hell is this about? I have no idea. I mean, obviously... Oh, well, wait a minute, look at this! What the... The Sith Lords! Maul and Kytus! Now they jump the reactors in another part of the building. This is complete utter chaos. All these teams are trying to gain momentum heading into that tag team turmoil match to crown the inaugural UCWL tag team champions as Darth Maul launches Akasan into the hood of that car. Thank God it's not my car. And now look at this. MI-13 and the Wing Commanders continuing to battle on the other side of the building. I mean, now I think we're going to need security. Oh, Jesus. Marshall launching Union Jack into that door, and then slamming the door into Union Jack's face. This is just getting completely out of hand here, ladies and gentlemen. And the thing is, we only know five of the teams in that tag team turmoil match. Oh, God! Akasan just launched Dark Ball into the windshield of that car. And now Akasan with a Hangman's neckbreaker on a Darth Kitus. Maul's been laid out cold. Oh, God, there's a DDT. I believe both members of the Sith Lords have been laid out cold here. The Black Dragon's down. The Sith Lords are down. And now we got MI-13 and the Wing Commanders battling it out here. And the thing is, we only know five of the teams in the turmoil match. There's still five other tag teams that are going to debut at Cold Day in Hell. And ladies and gentlemen, that's all the time we have here for you right now. Hopefully we can get the situation under control. Oh God. Oh Jesus. The Wing Commanders have laid out MI-13. And yeah, that's going to be all the time we have here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. We'll see you next time.